Please be seated. Good afternoon to everyone. I am Pastor Phil Clark, and I am extremely honored that Mary and the family invited me to have the honor of officiating Bob or Robert's funeral. And for each of you, welcome to you. A few notes. Following the service, those that are going to the cemetery, want to let you know that once we leave the Charleston city limits, the funeral procession will obey all traffic laws. So if you come to a stoplight, or we do, we will be stopping or pausing. Don't assume that people will stop for us. Hopefully they will, but in the Charleston area, we always have to watch those things. So, secondly, when we do get to the Hopewell Baptist Church Cemetery, there will be restrooms and water available for everyone. So, just to let you know those things. As we gather today, we gather to celebrate the life of a man who has touched so many in so many ways, who has given so much of his time and effort to make other people's lives very special. And for me, I know Bob for all of about 4 or 5 hours. But what he told me and shared with me helped me to understand that he was a man who had so much to offer, and he shared so much. And the Navy stories we told, I was a Navy chaplain, and he was in the Navy in World War II, a little ahead of my time. And the two of us just shared and enjoyed each other so much, as shipmates always do, or any military people do. When we get together, we share many stories, many memories, good times and bad times, but we know that we love our country, we love our Lord, and we love each other. And that's what we come to celebrate this day. Welcome to you in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our brother Robert, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Robert. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. I share with you today a few scriptures. One of Bob's favorite ones was from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. You anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I share with you also from Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 11 through 13. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call on me and come to pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord. And from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 6. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I go, you may be also. And you know the place where I am going. Thomas said to Jesus, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. In the brief time that I got to know Bob, and probably it will help you to understand how I did get to know him, at Mary's house where they were, they needed a ramp built, and they contacted the Tri-County Veterans Network, and Tim Taylor, who is in charge of that, asked me, who I serve also as not only a full-time pastor, but as a Lutheran campus ministry pastor at the Citadel. And he asked if I might be able to get together a group of cadets who could come over to Mary and Bob's and be able to build this ramp. And when we arrived, Mary told me that Bob had been in the Navy, and I said, oh, I was a Navy chaplain. And so she, at a certain time, said, he'd really like for you to come in and visit with him. Well, I had no idea that visit would last all the way to lunch, but we had a wonderful time, and we shared stories, and we talked, and I really sincerely felt as if I knew Bob for many, many years. And I think people who met him, that's how you felt. He was warm, friendly, and made you feel as if you had been a lifelong friend or family member. And that's evidenced by how many of you are here. Your hearts and your lives have been touched by his and by his giving. He gave very, very much, from what I understand. And so today we give back to him as we glorify God and praise God for his life for us. At this time, I'm going to invite the family members that have planned to do the eulogy to come forward, please, for that.
Good afternoon. I feel honored and privileged to be standing here today telling you about our uncle. Uncle Bob was a man of great honor, wisdom, intelligence, love, and kindness. He was a man with a very big and giving heart. And I know that to each and every one of you here today, he was something. He was a beloved companion, father, grandfather, brother, uncle, and friend to so many. But to us, he was a history teacher, cursive writing instructor, bingo player extraordinaire, dessert lover, honored veteran, advice giver, stand-in grandpa, gator driving instructor, school project mentor, a fantastic storyteller, and the list could go on and on. Since we were kids, there aren't many memories that don't include Uncle Bob and Sissy. They have always been there for us. From holidays to birthday dinners, to school programs and projects, to graduations, to writing college essays, to special events, to the birth of our children, and then back around to doing all those same things for our kids. I have so many wonderful memories at Uncle Bob's farm. Holiday dinners were the best. I have spent countless hours napping on his couch or in the back room. I have also spent countless hours painting all of that white fence on that farm for a high school trip to Europe. Uncle Bob always had a great idea for science projects and helped me write many history papers along the way. But what I remember the most are the small conversations, just talks about what was going on in my life and about the latest book he was reading. There are not many occasions that Uncle Bob missed. He wasn't a big fan of Miyabi's, but he always came because he knew that was one of our favorite birthday spots. He was at T-ball and softball games when it was unseasonably hot in Charleston and was there to hug me on some of the hardest days of my life. I could always count on his warm smile and his gentle words. When my kids started school, Uncle Bob and Sissy took carpool a day or two a week. They would go pick them up and spend the afternoon doing homework, playing bingo and checkers, and eating dinner. One day, Uncle Bob discovered that schools were no longer teaching cursive, and he was very upset about that. So he went out and he bought cursive workbooks and took it upon himself to teach each one of my children how to write cursive. He wanted to know how would they ever be able to sign their name on an important document if he didn't teach them. He also spent a lot of time teaching them about history and patriotism. I can truly say that all three of my kids enjoyed every minute of these visits with Uncle Bob. He imparted his love of history on them, and if asked today what their favorite subject was in school, they'll tell you it was history. I would like to close with a poem by Robert Louis Stevenson. This poem is special to me because not only does it remind me of the life that my father lived, it reminds me of the life Uncle Bob has always strived to live as well. A man is a success who has lived well, laughed often, and loved much, who has gained the respect of intelligent men and the love of children, who has filled his niche and accomplished his task, who leaves the world better than he found it, whether by an improved poppy, a perfect poem, or a rescued soul, who never lacked appreciation of Earth's beauty or failed to express it, who looked for the best in others and gave the best he had. Our Uncle Bob gave the very best he had every single day until his very last day. He lived a life that earned him the admiration and respect of each and every person here today. His giving heart and generous spirit has most definitely left this world better than he found it. He most certainly always saw the best in me, and I am so thankful for the role he played in my life.
This time we have a very special reading of the poem Crossing the Bar.
Hi everyone, I'm Tony Cadden, I'm Mary's favorite cousin. Holly, that was very good, and that's a hard act to follow. Bob Withers, man, talk about a life well lived. When I got here tonight, I was talking to Susan, and that was the first thing she told me about what a wonderful person he was. And I kind of jokingly told Susan that I've done this kind of stuff before a couple of times. And sometimes you got to scratch your head a little bit to find good things to say about somebody. But we could be here all afternoon talking about Bob. But yeah, what a life. You know, everybody's seen the pictures. They've seen the history of Bob's life. And everybody knows how much he did for people. And I was one of those people. When Mary asked me to speak last week, I told her it'd be an honor. And when I got home, I tried to remember the first time I ever met Bob, and I could not. But what I do remember is it probably took a minute or two to realize what a good human being he was. And I think we'd all agree with that. I can't imagine anybody not finding Bob that way. For 20 years, I coached the American Legion baseball team here in Charleston. And for 20 years, we had to raise a substantial amount of money to put the team on the field. And what we did is we went out and asked business people and folks we knew, you know, could they give us money, basically. And all those people that we went out and asked were very generous, very gracious. But we never had to ask Bob. Bob always came to us. And for 20 years, I never had to call Bob. Bob called me first to find out, you know, when you're coming by to get the check. And after 20 summers of doing that, I retired from that job. And the team kind of went out of business for about the next 10 or 12 years. And last year, me and a couple of guys just thought about bringing the team back. And as soon as Bob Withers got word of that, he was our first person to donate. I think he referred to it as startup money, I think is what he deemed it. But the other thing that Bob and I were talking about one day, I knew that he and Mary were real involved in the honor flights. And I don't know if you guys are familiar with the honor flights, but that's where they go up to Washington, D.C. and take the veterans to see the memorials, the World War II Memorial, the Vietnam Wall, and the Korean Memorial. And Bob was telling me all how it worked. And we all know how patriotic Bob was. And, you know, I was thinking, man, I'd like to do that. I'd like to be a chaperone and go up there, you know, and take care of one of the veterans, you know, that day. And I thought, man, that's kind of be my patriotic duty to do that. Until Bob told me how much it cost to be a volunteer. And then I found, well, wow, maybe I'm not as patriotic as I thought I was. Got home and got a phone call, and Bob being Bob, he said, I want to pay for you to go do it. And just to say what a day it was would be putting it mildly. But anyway, we could sit here and talk about things like that with Bob. Everybody's got those stories. But the last thing I wanted to say, you know, I'm a baseball guy, and the great Brooklyn Dodger, Jackie Robinson, made this statement, and I think it's incredibly appropriate for Bob. Said, a life is not important except in the impact it has on others' lives. And that kind of says it all, guys. Bob had an impact on everybody here, and we're all better off because of our contact with Bob. I want to thank Mary for allowing me a couple minutes to speak. I'd like to thank Bob's family for allowing me to come up, and thank y'all.
I'm pressing on the other. afternoon. I am sad but honored to read the crossing the bar, which was a special poem to Bob. Many of you may not know how Mary and Bob met. Mary's mom introduced him to her many years ago at Hopewell Baptist Church, where he will be buried. I also want to tell you how special he was to Mary, Mary's family, and me. He was father to Diane and Clay, grandfather to Taylor and Claire, but he was a father figure and uncle to me, my daughters, and grandchildren. He was a special Uncle Bob to many of Mary's nieces and nephews, and Uncle Bob to his nieces and nephews, especially the Markham family, who loved him as a grandfather. He was a loving brother to his siblings and constantly stayed in touch with Susan and Harriet. He was a man of integrity. He was caring, soft-spoken, honest, very patriotic, very generous, and did not expect anything in return. Bob was a good listener and advisor to me throughout the 40-plus years. He has been a wonderful part of our lives, and I, as well as my daughters and grandchildren, will miss him immensely. But we are grateful for the years and wonderful memories he has given to us. Crossing the bar is a metaphorical image of a sunset and the evening star to suggest that something is coming to an end. Bob's life with us hasn't come to an end because of the wonderful memories he has left all of us with. His life has continued beyond the sandbar of this shore into his eternal home with our Lord. And one day we will see him on the other shore waiting for us. Crossing the bar. Sunset and evening star and one clear call for me. And may there be no moaning of the bar when I put out to sea. But such a tide as moving seems asleep, too full for sound and foam, when that which drew from out the boundless deep turns against home. Twilight and evening bell, and after that the dark, and may there be no sadness of farewell when I embark. For though from out are born of time and place, the flood may bear me far, I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. We will miss Bob, and we love Bob, but we will see Bob again on the other shore.
It's always an honor when we get to hear or sing the Navy hymn. And so at this time, I'd invite all of you to stand as we hear the Navy hymn played. Eternal Father.
Oh.
Let us pray together the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Now we prepare to send our shipmate on his way. This is the commendation. We commend his body to our Lord Jesus Christ, and when we go to the cemetery, then we will commit it to the ground. Let us commend Robert Bob to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Bob. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Bob, fair winds and following seas. Let us go forth in peace. Those that can go along with us to the cemetery, you're invited to follow along. You have another announcement? And a reminder that we will, once we leave Charleston city limits, please be careful and cautious. We follow all traffic laws.
Come up and have a seat, please.
There's some empty seats up here. Come right ahead. Get out of the sun. There's some seats in there. Feel free to take one. There's some right over there.
Want more water? Are you in?
Coming underneath? Seated. falling leaves that lie scattered on the ground. The birds and flowers that were here cannot be found. All the friends that he once knew are not around. They're all scattered like the leaves upon the ground. Some folks drift along through life and never thrill to the feeling that a good deed brings until it's too late. They are ready to lie down there beneath the leaves that scattered on the ground. Your grave, there's no use taking any gold. You cannot use it when it's time for hands to fold. When you leave the search for a better home someday, the only thing you'll take is what you gave away. Lord, let my eyes see every need of every man. Make me stop and always lend a helping hand. Then when I'm laid beneath that little grassy mound, there'll be more friends around than leaves upon the ground.
Share with you a scripture from Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The Lord will not let your foot be moved, nor will the one who watches over you fall asleep. Behold, the keeper of Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will preserve you from all evil and will keep your life. The Lord will watch over you, your going out and your coming in, from this time forth, forevermore. And from the Gospel of John, chapter 11, Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live, and everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Grace and peace from our Savior Jesus Christ be with each of you. Let us pray. Holy God, holy and powerful, by the death and burial of Jesus, your anointed, you have destroyed the power of death and made holy the resting places of all your people. Keep our brother Robert, whose body we now lay to rest in the company of all your saints. And at the last, O God, raise him up to share with all the faithful the endless joy and peace won through the glorious resurrection of Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother Bob, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. May the Lord bless him and keep him. May the Lord make his face to shine on him and be gracious to him. May the Lord look upon him with favor and give him peace. Amen. Rest eternal grant you, O brother, O Lord, and light perpetually shine upon you, Bob. Fair winds and following seas. Now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you, each of you, complete in everything good, so that you may do God's will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in God's sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless each of you now and forever. Amen. Let us go forth in peace.
I guess so. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank goodness. Oh, yeah. Let's put it in a case over there.
My sister Esther, and you need to stand in the shade.
Well, you're not standing in the shade, Aunt Mary.
And this is my beloved Holly. I know you've heard me talk about Holly. She's like my own. Okay. And this is Jeffrey. This is Craig.
Well, I flirted with this little fella.
I know. I threw that kisses the whole time. And this
I
is.
Did. You liked it, didn't you?
And that's Rosanna.
Hi.
And that's Seth Robert.
And that's the ball.
Isn't that precious?
Yeah. Holly, this is my other family.
I'm Holly, too.